The holidays are known to bring families and friends together. However, that is not the case for everyone. First News reporter Kyle Alexander talked to mental health experts and learned what it's like for people who spend the season alone.
Norman Rockwell painted the ideal image of family over the holidays. Multiple generations gathered at the table for dinner, all enjoying the comfort a family provides.
But that's not the case for every family over the holidays. Some have to deal with estrangement and separation from their family members.
It increases their loneliness, their stress levels, it aggravates some of their symptoms.
Dr. Sarah Momin is a psychiatrist for Trumbull Regional Medical Center. She says lots of factors lead to family estrangement.
A lot of family dynamics, problems, parent-child issues, sometimes with the mentally ill, maybe substance abuse problems.
There's always those people who just tend to be alone and don't have a lot of people in their lives at this point, and I think they're kind of forgotten about.
Marcy Patton works for the Columbiana County Mental Health and Recovery Services Board. She says estrangement can cause feelings beyond loneliness, anxiety, depression, and sadness, to name a few. Patton said these feelings make people feel like they aren't meeting traditional expectations.
You should be happy and you should, you know, be enjoying this time, and then you start to judge yourself because you're not feeling that way.
So what can those experiencing loneliness do to help get through the holidays?
You don't want to, you know, sit on social media all day comparing everyone else's holidays with their families, with yours if you're struggling with isolation.
Make realistic expectations. Don't put too much on your plate. You know, plan ahead and kind of decide what can you realistically do.
If you know anyone that might be feeling lonely this holiday season, give them a call. It might just lift their spirits. Reporting for WKBN 27 First News, I'm Kyle Alexander.